Hi, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your Lord's Day Sunday afternoon Devo and your Daily Bread Devo, episode 601, part 2, for Sunday, January 16, 2021. Today we're going to be talking about darkness and light. And I said that right, 601, part 2. If you haven't seen episode 600, which was yesterday, and it was done live, go back and watch it. Then you'll be able to see the last part of the Abraham miniseries, and then the yesterday's Life by Death in the Daily Bread, which both of them are together. That way it's just all one day video, so it's a one part video. But and this morning I started a new continuation in the book of Genesis, but it's basically a continuation of the Abraham story, but yet we're going to be talking about other characters. Like today we talked about Lot, tomorrow we talk about somebody else. We talk about Isaac on Tuesday, and then Wednesday and Thursday we talk about Jacob. So, continuations of the family, some of the family members of Abraham. But all from the book of Genesis. So, but if you're excited about this episode 601 part 2, smash that like button. Comment what you like about the Daily Bread book. If you happen to have one and read it every now and then. But if you haven't picked them up, get hold of them. And when you watch these videos, you can read along with me. Sorry about the light changing. I put that book up a certain way, and it makes the focus of the camera go. So I'm on the webcam, the camera on my computer. It's the only camera I have right now. I need to get some money and get me a regular camera to where I could take out. Because I'm planning on going to some mini golf courses in the next few weeks. Some local in my area. And I'm going to try to record some videos and put them on my other channel to basically try to get that channel going. And if I get those mini golf videos, I might pick up a lot of people. And if I could share it on the BHV, the group with the Brooks Holt group for the mini golf on Facebook, I could share it. Say, hey, look, come to this channel and watch me play mini golf I can play some mini golf, but I've not been out there and played like Brooks does. But hey, I know my way around a mini golf course. I've played a few courses, and I'm gonna try to hit some of these local ones and share them and show Brooks, like, hey, come to this area and do those courses, and I'll come play with you. And we can team up. Boom. I could probably get my foot in the door and get something done about going to Nashville. So, but sorry for rambling. But today we're going to be talking about darkness and light from Allison Kedia Kaeda. It's K-I-E-D-A. Kieda. That sounds about right. Kieda. And we're derived from John chapter 3, verses 1 and 2, and then the verse of all verses, 16 through verse 20. So you know all know 3:16. It's the verse of all verses. For God so loved the world. Yep. Yep. That one. So, if you're excited, smash that like button. Well, I already asked that, but share the video and channel with your family and friends and help me get more subscribers. I still want to get to the 100 subscriber mark pretty soon. I want to build it up to 100. And then from 100, then I'm going to go to 1,000. And that'll be, I'll start getting monetized at 1,000. So, but if I can figure out how to get to the other channel, get another camera to record my mini golf games, then I'll be able to share it and put it on that channel, which that channel is going to be mainly for that and some other miscellaneous stuff. But this channel is mainly for the Devos. So, I'm also going to be for music, sharing my music when I get going in Nashville. So, on the other channels. So. But darkness and light. Allison writes, as I sat in the courtroom, I witnessed several examples of brokenness of our world. A daughter estranged from her mother, a husband and wife who lost the love they once had and now shared only bitterness. A husband who yearned to be reconciled with his wife and to be reunited with his children. They desperately needed changed hearts, healed wounds, and for God's love to prevail. Sometimes when the world around us seems to hold only darkness and despair, it's easy to give in. It's easy to give in to despair. But then the Spirit who lives inside believers in Christ, John 14:17, reminds us that Jesus died for the brokenness and pain. When he came into the world as a human, he brought light into the darkness. John 1:4-5 and in 8:12, which says, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. So we see in this conversation with Nicodemus, who firmly came to Jesus in the cover of darkness, but left impacted by the light. John 3:1-2 and 19:38-40. Hang on just a second. Thought I was going to sneeze. So Jesus taught Nicodemus that God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, his only begotten son, that whosoever should believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. That's how I've always learned it. So, and that's John 3:16, the verse of all verses. So yet, even though Jesus brought light and love into the world, many remain lost in the darkness of their sin, verses 19 and 20. And if we're his followers, we have the light that dispels darkness. So in gratitude, let's pray that God will make us beacons of his love. Sorry. And that comes from Matthew 5:14-16. And I believe that 5:16 is, let your light shine before men. Something along that line. Let your light so shine before men. I think that's the part I remember. In fact, let's look it up. John 5:14-16. No. No, that ain't the... What? I know there's a verse from John that says... Or maybe that's Matthew 5:16. Sorry about that. But when... Excuse me. Like a dry spot. So when has your hope been renewed through remembering that God loves you? And how can you share Christ's light with others? Let me know an observational answer to those questions in the comments, if you feel like it. You don't have to. But ponder those questions by saying, thank you, God, for coming to save me from the darkness of sin and despair. And help me to remain in your light. So today's Bible reading is Genesis 39-40 and then Matthew 11. So So coming up in tomorrow's part two, on Monday, for Monday, we're going to be talking about, we're going to learn how to brave your storm from Patricia Rayburn again. And this is derived from Hebrews 12, 1-3 and 12 and 13. So, stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes. But coming up later tonight at 7, after 7, is your weekend number 3. Your number 3 weekend Devo video from the Are You Ready for a New Year Weekend series. And the third R of a new year, restoration. New Year's restoration. Like the first week, the first weekend, which was New Year's weekend, the first of the month, we talked about New Year's resolution. Last weekend we talked about New Year's revolution, and then this week we talk about, and then this week we're going to talk about New Year's restoration. Then next week we talk about New Year's renovation. And then the fifth and final, it's going to be New Year's relocation. So see how all words begin with R. So, but stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes. But y'all see that after 7. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God. And He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Lord's Day, Sunday afternoon. Come back again tonight for weekend number 3 of Are You Ready for a New Year and New Year's Restoration. And we'll see what that's all about tonight. But until then, goodbye.